Okay, so I've got a 0.1 gram John Walker float. This is not a gimmick, you know, it's no incentive for me to try and sell floats. Okay, so it's a 2mm hollow bristle, and then we got a nice thick stem as well, wire stem. Okay, a nice diamond shape, so it gives lots of stability. We've got literally three number 11 stots, and what's good about stots, they just sink a little bit slower than what shot do. Got 018 mainline, and then got an 012 hook length. Now 018 might seem a bit heavy for this time of year, but we're on middle pool, and sometimes you might need to step up your hook lengths to like maybe even 014. I've got a 4mm lassoed pellet with a size 18 T911 hook. Now the reason why I use lasso pellets is my hook pellets is the same as my feed pellets, but I put a tiny bit of water with them, and what happens is it just takes the edge off them. Also, when I put the lasso on it, it actually looks like a pellet that's been in the water for a long time. If you just use a like fresh pellet like so, then I don't believe you're gonna get as many bites as quick. You'll probably find that when you lasso it, you'll probably start getting bites maybe after a quarter of an hour, 15 minutes, when the actual pellet has become soft. So therefore, to speed up the process, just a tiny bit of water, nothing else, no fancy additives or anything like that. Literally just a little bit of water, and just takes the edge off them. In my opinion, you're going to get bites so much faster this time of year. You can do it with a band, but a band tends to squash your pellet and makes a bit of a mess. So a lasso, in my opinion, is so much better. Okay, so doing a lasso. So you've got the lasso like so. Can't stress enough about using a four-legged baiting tool. So just literally put it in, open it up, and get your soft pellet, and literally spread it in like so. And what you can see is that, like that lasso, because that pellet's slightly soft, that digs into the pellet. For me, that is just so much more natural than a band. Like I said, if you could use a band on it, but the trouble is it's gonna squash the pellet, and it's not gonna look very good, it's just gonna be a mess.
So the bites will still be very, very delicate. It's looking for little tiny dinks. Just have one there, look. Just gently pull it to the left, look, just away from the shoal. Nice light elastic, essential.
Okay, so just take your time, just ship it back nice and slow. Because like I said, that they can be literally just in the skin, so that's why you want quite soft of elastic. And also, not that we're fishing shallow, but I do it a lot, especially here, is just feed it again, just so you line up the next one. Because when you've got that fish, undoubtedly, it's probably spooked a few in the shoal. So when you refeeding it while playing the fish, hopefully that'll just line up for the next one. Just proof in the pudding, if I can hold it up, is literally, just don't want to drop it, is up right in the skin, look. So I'm really paranoid about dropping the fish. So look, the little tiniest little like movement, and obviously that fish, you know, the hook's come out really easy. So beautiful Manor Farm Leisure F1, probably about, I don't know, £1.5, £2 maybe. We're getting back. It's already pleasure fishing.